Hello, welcome to another video in our GoJS beginner video series. This video will explain and demonstrate some of the most common GoJS GraphObject properties used for defining various appearance and behavior specifications for diagram components. Using GoJS requires programming in JavaScript and familiarity with HTML and CSS. You will benefit from previously viewing Building Parts with GoJS, Parts and Panels, which delivers an explanation of parts, panels, and graph objects and how they interact with each other. There are hundreds of properties used to set appearance and behavior of GoJS graph objects. This video will go over some of the most common properties for various kinds of graph objects. Understand that there are many more that will not be covered. You can learn more about all these properties at gojs.net. To demonstrate these GoJS graph object properties, we'll build a node template comprised of a text block and an auto panel holding two shape elements. This is the basic template that we will modify by specifying properties for its graph objects. If you do not understand what this is, please watch our video, Building Parts with GoJS Templates. This is what a node with this template looks like now in a diagram. Note that the text block is stacked above the auto panel, since the node's panel type is vertical. We'll modify the text block element first. We set graph object properties by passing an options object with key value pairs to the graph object constructor. The first property we'll set is the text property. The text property can also be set with a string argument to the text block constructor. If we set the text property explicitly in the graph object properties object, this overrides whatever we set it to with the string parameter. The string parameter denoting the default text for a text block is optional. It is just provided as an option for convenience, as sometimes one may wish to only specify a text block's text and no other properties. Now, if we load the page, we see that the text block's text, which used to appear as the string text, has been overridden and now displays the string example. Another common property for GoJS text blocks is the font property. This property's value must be a valid CSS string describing a font. The font string can accept several CSS properties, but they must be in a specific order to render correctly across all browsers. The correct order is font style, font variant, font weight, font size, font family. We'll set our text block's font using a string that denotes all these possible properties. The string we'll use is italic, small caps, bold, 12 point, Georgia, serif. Now, look at what we have. The font of the text block has changed to align with the CSS style string we provided to the text block's font property. The stroke property of a text block determines the color of the text. The value of this property can be any valid CSS color string, including CSS named color values, hexadecimal values, RGB values, or HSL values. Let's set our text block stroke to purple. The final text block property we'll observe is the editable property. It takes a Boolean value and determines whether or not to allow in-place editing of the text block's text string. Let's set this to be true and reload the page. Now, the text appears as before, but it's purple, and we can edit it by double-clicking and typing. Next, we'll observe some common properties of the shape graph object. First, we'll set the figure property explicitly here, which overrides whatever we set it to with the string parameter. The string parameter denoting the desired figure for a shape is optional. It is just provided as an option for convenience, as sometimes one may wish to only specify a shape's figure and no other properties. We'll set the figure property to ellipse. Now, load the page. The shape appears as an ellipse now instead of a rounded rectangle, as we've overridden the figure property. We'll set the fill, stroke, and stroke width properties for the shape as well. The fill property corresponds with the color the shape is filled in with, and can be any valid CSS-supported color string. Let's set it to pink. The stroke property accepts the same CSS-supported color string values, and corresponds with the color the shape is outlined with. Let's set it to purple. The stroke width property accepts numbers as its value, and determines how thick the shape stroke is in pixels. Let's set it to 10. Now, look at what we have. The shape is pink and outlined with a thick purple stroke. Let's examine some properties of the picture graph object. First, change the second element of our auto panel to a picture. We'll set three properties for the picture element in this example. The most common property for a picture element is the source property, which sets the picture's source URL, which can be any valid image, such as a PNG, JPEG, or GIF URL. As with textblock.text and shape.figure, we can set this either with the second parameter in our picture constructor or within the third parameter, the property options object. Let's set it with the second parameter this time. Set our picture's source property to a placebar URL, which is a simple service for placeholder images. The URL we provided here specifies an image with a width of 300 and a height of 200. Now, load the page. We see the picture is contained within the shape, since these elements belong to an auto panel, so shape, the main element of that auto panel, stretches to surround the picture. The next two properties we'll observe are not picture-specific properties, but are properties that can be set for any graph object, including pictures. The first of these is the desired size property. This property sets the desired size of a graph object. Its value type must be go.size. When constructing an instance of go.size, the first parameter specifies width, and the second parameter specifies height. Let's set the desired size property of our picture to a new go.size instance with a width of 150 and a height of 100. Now, if we load the page, we see the picture appears with these dimensions instead of the old 300 by 200 dimensions. Next, we'll observe the margin property. Again, this is not a picture-specific property and can be set for any graph object. This property denotes the size of empty area around a graph object. Generally, this property accepts values of type go.margin. A go.margin instance is created with four number parameters, which correspond with the top, right, bottom, and left margin values, respectively. Alternatively, the margin property may be supplied a number, and the margin property will be set to an instance of go.margin with that number as all its parameters. Let's set the margin property of our picture as a new go.margin instance with a top margin value of 25 and 0 for all other parameters, denoting no empty space around the left, right, and bottom of the picture. Now, load the page. The picture appears within the shape as before, but with 25 pixels of empty space above it. Finally, we'll examine some properties that can be applied to parts, such as nodes, links, and groups. We'll explore these properties by setting them for our node graph object. By default, we can select and delete our node. If we set the selectable property to false, we can no longer select the node. See? And if we set the deletable property to false, we can no longer delete the node. Let's set both these values back to true, though understand this is not necessary, as their default values are true, but it helps to see them clearly. Next, let's examine the resizable and rotatable properties. Their default values are false. Setting them to true allows a part to be resized or rotated. We'll do this now. You see how handles appear on the node when it's selected? These handles can be dragged to resize the node or moved to rotate the node. Sometimes you may want only a specific element of a part to be resized or rotated. For this, GoJS allows you to specify the resize object name and rotate object name properties. These properties' values are strings that correspond with a named element within the part. To use them, first, we must name an element in our template. Let's name our auto panel, panel. Then, we'll set the resize object name property for the node to the string panel. Now, see what we have. When we resize the node, only the auto panel and its elements are resized. The text block, the only element in the node not contained by the auto panel, remains unaffected. We can do the same thing for the rotate object name property. Set it to panel, and then go back and see what we have. Now when we rotate, only the auto panel and its contents rotate. Those are all the graph object properties we're going to look at for now. Remember, there are hundreds more, and we've just taken a cursory glance at all GoJS has to offer. To learn more about using various graph objects and their properties, visit the intro pages or peruse the full API documentation on gojs.net. You may be interested in watching our video Exploring a GoJS Application in Real Time Next, which ties together many concepts of these beginner videos and shows how one might develop with GoJS in real time. Head over to gojs.net to see hundreds of samples, read more about GoJS features on the intro pages, or peruse the full API documentation. Sign up for an unlimited free trial, and you'll get 30 days of developer-to-developer support for free.